And you know, it's bittersweet because, you know, we all die on the show, so
it's waiting.
It is, but there's a terror in it too, because it's like people don't know when their script comes up. You know what I mean? So it's hard to really kind of relax into it a bit because you kind of think that at any point you're gonna go.
Right.
But you know, I made friends for life, and you know, Scott Wilson, who plays Herschel, he's like my family now. I mean, I spend my birthdays with him. It's like he's like good Santa. yeah, it was wonderful. So I feel very blessed to have, you know, been a part of it. But I ain't dead yet.
I'm a fan of the comics, so Andrew's one of my favorite characters from the comics. You guys agree?
Yes.
Oh yeah. I'm still a fan of Rick and Andrea. That's my thing.
I can't say anything because he's got a new girlfriend. So.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so we are going to open the audience up for questions, because I'm sure you guys have lots of them, and it always goes by super fast. Are we doing a mic anywhere, or are we just yelling? Okay, we'll do that. So, you guys just raise your hands and we'll get right here. Look here.
What was the hardest episode for you to film?
Emotionally?
Yeah, like what was the one that knocked you on your ass?
Probably when Amy died. That was so hard. And it was so hard, not just because of what was required of me emotionally, but because of technically how the day went. It was like an 18-hour day, and they shot my close-up at the end of the day, so I had to be trying to kind of hold back but still giving it, you know, and all of the other coverage. And then we did that, I think, at 3 a.m. I think it was 2 or 3 takes, and then 2.5 hours later I got on a plane and went to ComiCon. So you know, it was that was surreal. And then I think the second by far would be my death, obviously, because I, you know, who wants to die?
It's like the final goodbye. Kind
yeah, the final goodbye. And then the third would be Prey, when Morrissey was chasing me for an entire episode, because it was literally like, I would get up at like 3:45 in the morning, go to set, and just run.
Yeah.
And I hate running. So, yeah, that was pretty intense.
How do you think Andrea would have acted towards Negan?
You know, that's a hard thing. I mean, I haven't watched it, but I didn't watch it when I was on it, just because I don't like to be scared. Jeffrey Dean Morgan is one of my favorite actors. He's one of my crushes. I think he's really hot. So it would be very hard to be objective because he's so cute.
It's hard to like somebody that is so evil.
But, you know, as a character, obviously anybody that was hurting my friends, I mean, I would have done everything I could to, you know, taken him out. I mean, he did some terrible things.
Let's go over here. Yeah?
Was there any discussion about having Andrea hook up with Dale during the show?
Yeah. Of course. I mean, that was what was supposed to happen. I mean, we had so many changes that happened with showrunners coming and going, and so the show kept shifting. That was the plan, and then my new showrunner came over, and then I all of a sudden was with the governor, which was never supposed to happen. And it just all kind of found a new path with the new kind of, you know, leader of the show. But that would have been sweet. I mean, he was such a great character. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I wish there'd been, there was so much love there anyways, you know, even though I gave him a really hard time in the beginning. But he loved Andrea in spite of herself, but she was just going through a hard time with all her grief. But even though we didn't have a romantic love, I think that we had a really deep love. So I'm glad we were able to explore that.
How was the secret keeping when you've got the script and you know what's happening and like people hounding you? How did you deal with keeping that a secret? And did you tell anyone?
What, that I died?
No, like just like you know what's happening before anyone else. So, like, did you have to tell people just because it was so hard to keep that big of a secret?
You know, it wasn't really hard because, you know, when you're on the show, we were living in the backwoods of Georgia, and I didn't see my friends for 3 years. I barely saw my family. I mean, we were isolated, and it becomes your new family. So you kind of are cut off from the outside world quite a bit. And you know, if a friend texted or joked, and you know, I would be like, ha ha ha, you know, like, never gonna happen, you know. It wasn't that hard to keep a secret.
Okay.
It was hard after season 3 when I was, like, you know, on the Ellen show and, you know, Larry King and whatever talk shows I was, and I was like all happy and like, God, everyone dies on the show, and meanwhile I'm like bawling inside because I've just been killed. I mean, that was very difficult, you know, kind of trying to keep it together and not say anything. But overall, no.
I saw your hand go up first. The hat?
Yeah, so what's next career-wise for you, Laurie? I mean, you did The Walking Dead. You did a great job on that. What are you working on now?
The Americans. Does any woo! The Americans? Yeah. It's an amazing show. It's kind of paralleling what's going on in our world right now. It's all about Russian spies, America. I just finished season 5 and I'm going into season 6, so I'm really excited about that. And it's a completely different character.
Thank you so much for joining us today. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
How do you think Walking Dead should end?
Everyone.
Do you think it'll ever end?
It's never ending. It's not allowed.
Yeah, I think it's, I can't even imagine. I don't think it's going to end anytime soon. I think it's going to go on.
It could go on forever.
I mean.
Well, that's what they want. That's what Robert Kirkman wants.
Yeah, he's making a lot of money. you know, wouldn't it be great if there was a cure? That would be nice. Some of the people that we really love that are still left, like, you know, make it and have a good life. Or
they all die.
Wait. It's like, was it Dallas where you wake up and it's all a dream? We get to all come back and we're all looking pretty and happy and rested. And it was like all a dream.
I really hope they don't go that way.
I knew.
We have a question right on the end over here.
What is your opinion on how Rick pronounces Carl?
Coral.
Do you know this joke?
No.
So, he says coral, like, I guess, like, coral, the color, coral. And that's just the joke, right? That's it? It ends there?
Coral.
Yeah. That's it. There's an ongoing joke about that in memes and things online. Is there anything else?
I guess that's just his accent.
Yeah. Right here in the way.
Can we expect to see you in Talking Dead at all?
Me?
Yeah.
Maybe. I was on The Talking Dead. I know that Rooker just came back.
Yes.
So if they invited me, I probably would do it. You know. Yeah.
Sure,
why not? Any questions in the back? In the gray? All the way in the back. Yeah. One question. If The Walking Dead is supposed to take place
about 4 years, how can you only see any changes to the season? Why is it going to be just summer? Summer's already over. No,
there were spots.
They were wearing jackets. Well, that's when we shoot it. I mean, I don't really know how they could, like, fake winter. Like 110 degree Georgian heat.
You were wearing jackets at the farm when you were running away. You had a wool-ish jacket on when Michonne found you.
Day.
Yeah. So.
You know, I mean, I don't know. I think that's just what's happened in terms of the shooting schedule, and there's only so much you can get away from the weather. But maybe they'll change that down the line. I don't know. It would be kind of neat to have them go through a winter. That's a production.
It does.
I watched The Mist. Like,
can I
explain my mom? I was wondering, what was
your reaction to the ending? It was a little sad. you know, my mother makes a joke, and she's like overseeing me die because I think I've died in like seven films at this point. Yeah, it was really sad, but I also thought that, you know, it's different than the Stephen King ending. It was more of a happy ending. Stephen King, I know, really liked our ending. I thought it was kind of, it was depressing, but I thought it was cool because it wasn't a Hollywood ending. I thought it just kind of made you think, and it kind of sat there. And I believe I just read something that is considered one of the best horror films. I just read an article about how it's like in the top horror films of all time. I don't know. I mean, it was dark and depressing, but I mean, is there ever really a happy ending with a horror film? It's like, well, everybody got chopped up and he ate my friends, but you know, we made it. I mean, that's not really a happy ending.
Hey, big fan of Walking Dead, but I'm just curious. I just happened to fall into an internet hole, and I was the other day. I rewatched for the longest time ever Silent Hill.
Mm.
How was that filming that?
It was cool. It was intense. I mean, that might have been harder than the Walking Dead physically. You know, my character just, my God, I never stopped. We never stopped. And there wasn't really CGI in this film. I mean, when Rhonda Mitchell and I were in the scene and the big knife was coming towards us, that was really a knife. Like, they didn't put it in later. And I would say the director, he was like this French dude, I was like, guy, we could slip. Like, he's like, you better be careful. I was like, wow, okay. Or when I died in that one and I was like put over a flame and there were spikes and stuff, I was really put over a flame. That was a real flame. Like, I kind of look back at some of my choices and I'm like, why did I do that? Why did I insist on a stunt double?
Yeah. They
want
to fear in your eyes.
They got it.
Did you have a favorite zombie death?
Pardon me?
A favorite zombie death.
Favorite zombie death.
A favorite zombie death? What does that mean?
Like a favorite zombie death from the show?
Yeah.
Just anyone?
Like someone I cared about dying from
a
zombie?
No, like a
or
walker.
The screwdriver through the face.
Oh, RV zombie.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you know what? They make a lot of money on that merchandise. Have you seen that? They have the little head
with the screwdriver.
Like, I did that. Seriously, I did that. Wow.
All right.
So, when you worked with Melissa McBride on The Mist and then got to work with her again on The Walking Dead, how was that? Was that cool to kind of see her?
She's awesome. She actually reached out to me last week, and I'm going to go see her in Atlanta. She is the kindest, sweetest person, and I'm so happy for her that she's playing a character that they, you know, because there was a time that they were going to kill her off, yeah. And then they changed their mind, and I'm really glad that they did what they did, because she's such a good person. She deserves so much success, and she's such a great actress, and I love the fact that they showed this evolution of this broken woman into a woman that's so strong, and I think that was really important.
You can see it in her eyes when she's acting, for sure. She's got a lot of heart in her.
Oh my God, she's one of the best. Yeah.
Let's get someone here. Wait.
They're pretty in pink over there.
Oh, we have two pinks.
Who do you think will make it to the end?
Carl.
Cool.
I think that's the answer.
Yeah.
And you say it right too.
Carl.
Cool. Yes, way in the back.
So you get into acting.
How'd you get into acting? Or decide to get into acting?
Decide that job as opposed to others.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, that's kind of a long story. Basically, I grew up in a family that's all in the business. My mother was an actress on Broadway. My father was an actor, writer, my stepfather is a director, my grandparents were big, 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 big actresses. I came out of the womb and they were like, ah, voila, an actress, you know? And I didn't really have a knack for it or think about it. It was kind of expected of me. And then growing up, you know, when all my friends were having fun and, you know, going on little trips and excursions, it was my way of making money. I got an agent and I'm like, yeah, I'll do a 7-Up commercial. Yeah, I'll do this. And it was like my way of being able to have fun. But I never thought it was something I was going to do. Probably because it's like anything. My family forced it on me. So I was like, yeah, whatever. Like, I'm not interested. And I went to McGill to be an investment banker. I studied economics. And then I think as soon as they got off my back and were like not, because they were devastated I was going to go to McGill. Can you imagine? I'm going to McGill, like, oh, you failed our family. You know, I think that as soon as they kind of, the expectations were off me, then I missed it. And then I was able to really discover it on my own, and I found this incredible guy, Larry Moss, and joined this theater company and read plays and fell in love with storytelling. And then there was no turning back, and I was like, this is what I want to do. I love being part of something where, you know, where you can turn off the sound and it doesn't matter where you are in the world or, you know, what ethnicity, what nationality, that we're all, we all want to love and be loved, and we all, you know, unite over storytelling, and that's something that, I don't know, it moves me. I'd be a lot richer if I was an investment banker.
Next question. Yeah, go ahead.
Besides yourself, who is your favorite Walking Dead character?
Besides yourself.
Besides myself. me. That's so hard to say. I mean, I love Herschel. I love Carol. I love Glenn. I think Rick is a rock star.
He's incredible.
T-Dog.
Everyone who's half dead.
You know, Daryl's pretty cute. You know,
he's pretty cute.
He's pretty cute. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I'm kind of partial to the OGs because those are the people that we built it together. But I don't want to leave anybody out. And
Shane,
he was fine.
Had to go there.
Yeah, easy on the eyes. All of them, except the meanies. I don't like the meanies. Bad guys.
You mentioned about the heat, like how warm it is in Georgia. Is there anything that they did on the set to allow you guys to cool down, or did they just say keep going?
Yeah, keep going.
Yeah. It's authentic.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's weird because it's like the heat is like unbearable, but at the same time, when there wasn't the humidity, like it almost felt like something's off, like the heat is almost its own character. And I think that the fact that we all look so, you know, a lot of that was the heat, and I think it helped all of our performances. You know, good for the skin.
Hey, just curious, how do you get into character, and also like how do you prepare yourself for like emotionally draining scenes?
On The Walking Dead?
Yeah.
Because it's different on everything. On The Walking Dead, the beauty is that it was written so well that it kind of, our world became so real to us and we were so sequestered that, like when Dale died, I didn't even have to think about it. I didn't have to prepare for it. I just showed up. But you have to understand that a lot of us were very methody. We were living it. You know, I kind of left Laurie Holden, you know, aside, and I was Andrea, you know, for the entire time I shot. So we built a world that became so real to us that it was our reality. And I think, I mean, I know Andy's very much like me. We just kind of, it was kind of hard to snap us out of it. And, you know, in general, I think, you know, with anything emotional, you just kind of, our imagination is very powerful. It's more powerful than people give credit to. And they've done all these studies where, you know, your mind doesn't know if it's real or if it's you know, your imagination, if you build it strong enough. And I think they, you know, hired a bunch of people that had really big, full hearts and were really brave.
So then was it hard for you to snap out of it when you had a very intense scene?
Very.
Like you would be down for weeks?
Very.
How did you get the opportunity to star in The Walking Dead? Like, did someone come up to you and say, do you want to try this out? Or?
Yeah.
How did you get the audition?
Yeah.
Frank Darabont called me and said, you know, you're perfect for the show that I'm doing. I think you're the perfect Andrea. And I was like, I don't even know what this is. And it's a comic book. And I was like, a comic book? How do you even act a comic book? Like, I didn't understand it at all. And I picked up the compendium, the Walking Dead compendium, and I read it over like a day and a half. And I was like up all night and I was crying and I was scared. And I was like, I cannot believe that a comic book is making me weep, is making me scared, that I can't stop reading it. And so that was that. It was just, it kind of came to me. Like, he came to Melissa McBride as well, and Jeff DeMunn, who played Dale. You know, I think the reason why it worked so well is that, you know, he was the one who put it all together, and he's a master craftsman, and our crew and our cast were all handpicked. And yeah, it was just, he just kind of knew. He knew us, he knew our work, and you know, I'm really grateful. Because none of us knew what it was gonna be. I mean, we thought, okay, it's AMC and it's gonna be a little zombie show and it'll have its niche. You know, some people will watch it. We didn't realize that it was gonna be this, you know, worldwide phenomenon.
I actually read the comics years and years before the show was even coming out, so I was very, very happy when I found out it was going to be a TV show. And I think they casted the first season perfectly. You are the perfect Andrea. I think he did an amazing job. Do you agree?
Yeah.
I think he did a very, very good job. Very good job of casting it. And I think that's a lot when it comes from somebody that is a fan of the comics, because but here are big comic book fans of anything and feel like we are the most judgmental people when it comes to movies and when they cast things. So I think, yeah, it means a lot. You guys were really good.
Thank you.
All right, we have more questions. We have time for some more.
Just look at her shirt. Right. Stand up, Michaela. Okay, this is loyalty. Get up here.
Oh, love it.
This little creature, okay, I have known her for years. She, like, I have seen her grow up. She had braces.
Oh my gosh!
And look at this shirt. Okay, stay with me for a second. Ask the question.
Out of everything that you've ever done, like every movie and TV show, what was your favorite to do?
Ooh. For what reasons?
Just like anything, like how fun it was, or like how much you enjoyed the cast?
The people, hands down, would be The Walking Dead. Did any of you watch The Shield?
Yeah.
The Shield. I loved The Shield because it was so incredible and it was so badass, and I loved the fact that I was able to bring down Vic Mackey, so that was like huge. I love being part of the Americans right now because I think it's truly one of the best shows in television history. I loved The Majestic because I felt like that showed my heart more than anything I've ever done. But I loved The Walking Dead because we were like the little train that could, and we like were a bunch of people that like came out in the midst of Georgia, and we didn't know what we were doing, but we just kind of put it out there, and the world responded, and It was just so special, you know. And I loved that I played a woman that was suicidal and had given up on life, and that she became a warrior, even though she had the worst taste in men. But yeah, that was a pretty special time. Yeah. Okay. I'll see you after. She said, I'll see you in Irish.
Every time there's some sort of drama, he's always missing. They're like, where is
he? That was a long time ago. Now he's gone. He's a good kid. I love Chandler.
It's too deep putting
controversy? I believe that we should all be positive and remember the good.
I like that.
Good. Yeah.
Yeah, are there any spots in Toronto that you have to come to when you visit? Like, what's your favorite place to go to?
That's a really good question.
I'm obsessed with the Little Italy, Ossington, King West area. I literally, like, walk and walk and just, you know, it's so amazing. I mean, Toronto is off the charts. I am so proud of the city. I go to a lot of restaurants, but, you know.
Do you have a favorite?
So.
Well, Queen Street was actually nominated as the second or first coolest places to live in the world by Vogue magazine.
Seriously?
Pretty cool.
But I also love what I'm hearing. I love to like go up to like Simcoe or Muskoka. Like I love, you know, I mean, Toronto's got it all. And you know, I have the same friends I've had since I was little, and it's like none of us have changed. We act like we're 12 when we're together, and you know, it's just I don't know. I feel like it's like I always say to my friends that coming to Toronto is like a warm blanket. You know, I just feel like oh, nice. I don't want to leave.
All right. Yes. Okay.
What music are you listening to right now?
Ooh, I'm not listening to music right now. God.
I'm the same way. People always ask me about music. I'm
so not cool. I mean, I'm a Pandora girl, so I just kind of like listen to like stuff that I love. That's kind of
that you know.
That I know. I like stuff that gets me up and gets me dancing.
Such as?
Just like cool, like Latin stuff, and then funky disco, and I don't know. I'm all over the place. It depends on my mood. God, I wish I really could answer that I don't really have a favorite. I just like certain genres. I like things that have like a great beat that just like are very soothing, sexy. And I need to go to Pandora and figure out what I'm listening to so I can answer that.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you have any humor stories or prank stories about people walking down the road?
Prank stories?
Anyone pranking? No, not prank stories. I mean, I was always in awe of the gifts that Norman Reedus would receive from females that question my gender.
Someone bit Norman Reedus at Walker's Donker.
Oh, did they do that?
Were you there for
that? No. But women have said Norman Reedus things that I can't even. I think someone took out their fake silicone boob and sent it by a FedEx.
Oh my.
Yeah, something like that. I mean,
how do you?
And worse. I mean, it's just kind of like, what were you thinking when you like posted that? You know. But no, we were a fun bunch, and we would listen to Michael Jackson's Thriller, and we would like. You know, do a zombie thing in the hair and makeup trailer and stuff. We laughed a lot. There was a lot of laughter. Pranks, I'm not so sure of, but but mostly a lot of dancing, the thriller.
Same one from this side.
I'm just wondering if you get recognized a lot, and Toronto being your home city, if you get recognized more here or anywhere else.
I get recognized in New York a lot. It's kind of a daily thing, to be honest. I mean, I think that everyone's kind of seen the show by now. Yeah, I mean, and it's worldwide because I think it's, you know, the most popular show in the world. I mean, if I wear stripes, I'm dead in the water. You know, because Andrea always wore stripes. So if I wear like a striped sweater, it's like,
you know how to hide.
All over the place, but it's nice. It's like, you know, I'll just kind of walk down the street and someone will be like, I love you, and I'll be like, what a nice thing to say. But people are very respectful here, you know. It's not I don't know, I mean, Canadians are very polite, so it's like they're or, excuse me, you know, sorry, you know, I love you, sorry.
Way back here.
Yeah, I was wondering, do you have like a creepy fan story?
A creepy fan story?
I do now.
Oh, I got a creepy fan story. Okay, yeah. Sorry if I'm offending you, lady, whoever you are, but I had a woman that came to a convention with a black Sharpie, and she asked me to sign her boobs. And I did
it! Did you do it because she asked? No,
this is where it gets crazy. She not only wanted me to sign them, she wanted me to sign it so she could make it a tattoo. And I was like, you don't want that. I did it anyways. That's what she wanted. She wanted that more than a selfie or an autograph.
How often do you get approached to do Canadian projects?
I just did a really cool film here. A really cool film that some people are aware of. I just did this really amazing film that I shot in Sault Ste. Marie called Piwacket. It's me, it's a two-hander with me and my daughter, Nicole Munoz, and it's made by the people who did Backcountry and the Witch, and it's like a psychological thriller with horrific elements, and it's going to be really good. Really, really good. So that's going to come out at the end of the year. It's probably going to hopefully be a TIFF, but if you love The Walking Dead, you will love this film.
What is this one called?
Piwacket. It's about witches.
That's a new thing.
Yeah, it's really, very cool, really yeah. Cool. Very emotional.
Yes,
right
here. Okay, I think we're picking up 10 people. Yellow hat?
Yellow hat.
I have the yellow hat.
Yeah, that's you.
Wait, if you had the chance to be in a movie that was made before you were born, what movie would it be? What character would you play?
God, that's tough because there's so many good ones. Well, my favorite movie of all time is Sound of Music. So I wouldn't have mind being the Weasel or something, you know? Wasn't that the best movie?
It
was the best movie. I love Dr. Zhivago. I would have loved to play Julie Christie's character. Oh my God, there were so many. They really wrote great parts for women back then. So the list is kind of anything Jessica Lange did. You know,
she's a great actress.
She's so great. She keeps killing it. Yeah, I mean, Dr. Zhivago is probably number one.
I haven't heard
it. It's amazing.
I like that.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Okay. We have time for a few more. Let's take one over here. Yes, Marsha?
What was your favorite
season to shoot?
I think season two. For the people, and I really loved being on the farm. It's tough because I loved season three because I loved Michonne and I didn't like that governor stuff.
Michonne and Andrew's relationship.
It was awesome.
Amazing.
I really had a hard time being separated from Rick and the group in season three. It was very, very hard on me, you know, because I just wanted it to end and it just went on too long. But that was the story. But I would say probably season one and two. Yeah, definitely. Because that was like when we built it, you know? There was like a purity then, yeah.
Okay, we have time for one more question, maybe two if they're fast. I'm gonna get you to pick the last one because I always feel bad.
You mentioned that your family has been involved in Broadway and acting. Would you ever consider doing Broadway?
100%.
Yes.
Yeah, it's on my bucket list. I really want to do a play. I want to do a juicy play. Yeah, for sure. Oh my God, I got fish to fry.
Yeah.
I got a lot that I want to do.
Do you have a favorite musical then?
Oh, that's hard. I loved Wicked. I loved Miss Saigon. Les Mis was wonderful. Annie was like the best. I mean, I grew up with Annie. I don't know.
They're all so good.
And then there's new fun ones like Fun Home, but Hamilton was the best thing I ever saw, ever.
I have yet to see Hamilton, but I hear very good things.
Oh, it's amazing.
Okay, we do have time for one more question.
I wanted to know, like, how soon when we're killed off, like, how far ahead of time did you find out, and how was your emotional reaction?
There had been rumors about it, but then I was told that it wasn't, they were rumors and it wasn't going to happen, so I was told the night before.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Did we all prepare
you
for that?
We're going to
Kalina.
No. Okay, can everybody...
They don't do that to people anymore. I think that it was something that they realized that they can't do that. And I think they've been very respectful to people moving forward. And there are very good people in production that actually care. And, you know, I just don't think that my situation was handled, you know, as it is now. And that's okay.
Well,
there was one more, and I hate to
miss. Oh, you want to get one more?
Yeah.
Sure.
Just really quick, I know you mentioned the Majestic earlier, so I was wondering if you could talk about your experience working with Farley Brothers or being carried on Dumb and Dumber 2.
Well, that was it was a silly movie, but it was the perfect movie for me after The Walking Dead because, like, I could not shed a tear or, like, do anything emotional after Andrea. Like, I really needed a timeout because it really kind of, you know, ripped apart my soul. So that was kind of the perfect, fun movie for me. I mean, it was surreal. I mean, I grew up watching Dumb and Dumber and, you know, they've done so many amazing movies, the Farley Brothers, and I've worked with Jim before, and I love Jeff Daniels, who's like, you know, so incredibly talented. Then Kathleen Turner, who's like kind of someone I've idolized since I was a kid. So it was just really surreal. I mean, I just was really happy to be a part of it because, you know, I've made a career playing so many badasses and, you know, crying and sobbing and like, and dying all the time. And then just to be kind of like, you know, almost wearing a little invisible mustache and trying to kill Harry and Lloyd, it was like, it was really fun. I was like, oh my God, this is like, it was a lot of fun to shoot. A lot of fun. And they have great senses of humor, obviously. Yeah. Can you imagine if we didn't? Yeah. Any more questions?
Yeah, does anyone have? Oh, see, then we have more. Let me see. Okay, we can do one more, but then we're going to get kicked out. Who wants to go? Last one? Does anyone have gone yet? You haven't gone yet. Okay.
We kind of talked about how you get into your role,
but do you have any creative process on how to get out and go back to be Laurie instead of the character that you play?
That's interesting. Okay, to get into a role, it's different for every character. It's funny because you were mentioning music. Music actually helps me get into characters, as it does Andrew Lincoln. If it's during a certain period of time, I'll read, you know, everything historically that was going on at the time, so I know what was going on politically, the music, the fashion, just, it was, you know, because they had different idiosyncrasies of how people spoke. And then I just try to you know, look at my life and see what parallels, how can I relate to this person? Like, have I lost someone? Have I, you know, unrequited love? You know, whatever emotions that you can kind of tap into, and if that doesn't work, then you build from your imagination. But it's different for every character. But in terms of getting rid of a character, I mean, that's, grieving a character is, it's different for everyone. Andrea took quite an amount of time, and still, you know, in me. You know, I'm very athletic, and so, you know, I find it very therapeutic to swim and to do Pilates and to do things physically. That helps me get out of my head. You know, the expression, the best way to get over someone is to get under someone else. sorry for kids here if they don't know what I'm talking about. To be creatively excited about something else is, I think, the best way to kind of let something go, you know. So
Chicks will play leapfrog.
I've never heard of that one.
Over under, right? Leapfrog?
Yeah,
right?
Leapfrog.
Yeah. Yes.
Leapfrog.
Yeah.
Any other questions?
There's one over there. Oh, see? We're going to take last one.
Different profession.
Different profession.
Investment banker.
I did like the bill. Well, it's twofold. I mean, financially, I think investment banking was a very smart, they do very well, you know, and I have a very math-orientated mind, so I know that's something that I would excel at. But I mean, to be honest, if I follow my heart, you know, I'm very into human rights, I'm very into children, and I want to help people. You know, I mean, I do that anyways in my life, you know, when I'm not acting per se, but, you know, making sure that, you know, being part of crusades and things that where we can prevent people from being abused, people from being hurt as much as is possible. That's, I think that's why I'm here, to be honest.
You're able to do that in this career as well.
Yeah. But do it even more.
Thank you guys so much for all of your questions.
What booth number am I? I'm still signing.
Yeah, so go and visit her at her booth. Everybody leave here, you go